Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my Atlanta Braves franchise mode series here in MLB The Show 16 on the PS4. We're just starting our second year in April of 2017 here. We've played, what, five games? We're 2-3, and we're traveling to the nation's capital to take on the Washington Nationals. They're 4-1 to start the season. Going to be a pair of aces here, Max Scherzer against Julio Teheran. See if we can get our third win of the season and even our record at 3-3. You see the pregame spotlight is on Max Scherzer, as well as Freddie Freeman, hitting .444 in a very small sample of games to start this thing off. One home run. All right, let's go to the top of the first, and Juan Lagares. He is going to go opposite field and get a base hit right there, leading off the ball game. So Lagares comes in and gets us started. Let's see if we can continue in the first inning to bring him around here. Conforto at the plate. We're going to ask him to bunt and put the sacrifice down, and he will do just that. Scherzer just does nip him at first base, and the sacrifice is a good one, but he thought he might have an infield single right there on the bunt. Josh Harrison, oh boy, 1-for-22. Big time struggles starting the season here. Might be trying too hard, and yeah, you know, just trying to be selective right there, but it bites him as strike three is called. He's now 1-for-23 on the young season. I'm sure he'll get it figured out, but right now he is struggling mightily. There is a walk to Freddie Freeman, so he will go to first base. And Scherzer having to work in this first inning. Two runners on, and now his 15th pitch. That's going to be Trace Thompson grounding out to first. So Scherzer does get out of the first, stranding two runners. We go to the bottom of the first, and here is Zimmerman up with a runner at second, and he's going to line that to right. It's down for a hit and off the fence. He'll stay at first, but he drives in the game's first run as Bryce Harper scores to make it 1-0. Let's go on now to second inning play, and that's Daniel Murphy getting around on one, and see you later. It's out of here to right field. Make it 2-0 Nationals. They're out to a hot start to start this season, 4-1, looking for their fifth win already, and it's because of hitting like this. Daniel Murphy comes through with a 402-foot blast off of Teheran, who had not given up a run coming into this game, I believe. Of course, he hadn't faced the Nationals yet on the season. That was one thing, and he hadn't left a pitch right over the middle of the plate like that. A miss in location makes it 2-0. Here is a base hit to right field. Going to be 3-0 now, Nationals, as they continue to put the runs on the board. That's Zimmerman coming through again. Now here with runners at the corners, a little bloop hit to center field, but it is going to fall, and that'll make it 4-0. Just doesn't seem to be Julio Teheran's day to this point, as that is a Jason Worth hit. It's 5-0 now with the Braves at bat, and it's Tyler Flowers taking the ball deep to right. Come on, get out of here. No, Bryce Harper's going to have room to make the catch on the warning track, and it's close but no cigar right there, as you see. Yeah, he drifts back here and is able to make the catch on the run, so nothing doing for the Braves right there. It's now 6-0 Nationals, 3-1 count, and Trace Thompson going to right. He hits the ball well. Can he get it out of here? No, that is also caught near the fence, and that'll end the inning. Max Scherzer's got the shutout going, and despite hitting the ball hard a couple times and deep, not deep enough to get it out of the park. Oh, what's this? Oh, we got a loose beach ball. Okay, well, the fans entertaining themselves one way or another. Beach ball gets on the field, and Bryce Harper will dispose of that. Speaking of disposal, yeah, the Nationals are disposing of the Braves in this one. 12-0. Harrison finally gets his second hit of the season. It's a gapper, and it may be an RBI. They're going to send the runner home, and he will score. So it's an RBI double for Harrison, who, well, there's nowhere to go but up with the struggles he's been having, so that's good to see right there. They get on the board finally. Freddie Freeman, he is going to ground out here, and that is going to do it for that inning. So they get one on the board. They avoid getting shut out. See a Danny Echevarria at the plate right now in the ninth inning, and he will hit this ball to left center. A dive, and he can't come up with it. That's going to roll to the fence. Echevarria will be into second, And you got something going in the ninth inning. And for him, that continues a hitting streak now at 8 games. It's a carryover from last year. 12-1 is still your score in the ninth. 3-2 count. Tyler Flowers, check swing, strike three. Ball game is over. Mercifully, it finally ends. And we take a thumping right there. Scherzer goes the distance. Not sure really why they bothered when he lost the shutout, but yeah, I guess it's a pride thing. He goes ahead and closes it out, and the Nationals win heftily to start this 3-game set in D.C., 12-1. Going to have to try to recover after that. Yeah, Josh Harrison, our best batter on the day, not doing much, just driving a run home late in the contest. So the second game also goes to the Nationals as we drop that one late. And now we're going to try to avoid the sweep by sending one of our newest additions, Robbie Erlin, out to the mound to see if he can stop the bleeding. Nationals take two to start the series. They want a sweep. We're going to go with the baby blue throwbacks here. Looking sharp, I guess. All right, let's see if that helps Josh Harrison's bat out at all. 2-1 count with two outs. There you go. Okay. Starting to figure things out a little bit. I think his average when he stepped to the plate there was like 0.064. So anyway, that will definitely rise when he gets a couple hit game under his belt. Freddie Freeman, he didn't exactly tag that ball. Tanner Roark's got all the time to throw him out, and he does just that. So the Braves get nothing in this inning. So Robbie Erlin to the mound. He's 0-1, but this is his first Atlanta Braves appearance, his debut, and we'll see how he fares. Here in the first inning with two outs, he gets strike three looking against Zimmerman. Does not like the call, but he set him up with some low pitches and then went with the high fastball to strike him out. We go to the third inning now, and you got a runner on the move, and that's Conforto getting the hit to center field. The hit and run works, and you now got first and third. I believe he was off because it was a 3-2 count and two outs. So not exactly a hit-and-run situation, but, you know, starting the runners when you have nothing to lose. That ball gets away, and runner coming home will score. All right, so we take a 1-0 lead on either a pass ball or a wild pitch. Tanner Roark uncorks one right there. And you see from the base runner's perspective, as that ball gets away and he sees he can easily get home on the play, Harrison waving Flowers home, and he will score. So we've got the 1-0 lead. Let's see what Robbie Erlin does with it. Fifth inning, that ball hit the right center field, and that is not coming back. So he's pitched really well up to this point, but that one, another mistaken location, and it's driven out of the ballpark. We've got a brand new tie game at one apiece. Now he's in a jam with the bases loaded and one out, and this is going to be a fly ball to right. It will be an out. However, speedy runner at third base will come home to score. You get the runner at second moving up to third as well. And it's now 2-1 in favor of the Nationals. So a couple walks, a hit, and then a fly ball. It bites him right there. And how about this? Hit hard in the gap to right center field. Rolls to the fence. And this runner going to come around third? Yes, he is. Not the greatest relay right there. Swanson's throw not in time. It's 4-1 Nationals as Jason Worth comes through with a clutch hit right there. Two outs, one on. This ball, deep to left. And you can kiss it goodbye. 6-1 Nationals as they're starting to get the route on again. I believe that's Rendon going deep to left field against Shea Simmons in relief. Okay, it's 6-1 in the ninth. 3-1 count. And oh my goodness, that guy got smoked in the head. Oh my goodness, I fear for that guy's life. Took it directly off the head. Wait. Okay, feeling a little groggy. Not fearing a concussion. I was fearing death. Let's watch this again. It's right back at his... Oh my goodness. Oh, that's hard to watch. Watch him stagger and fall. And then he just writhes in pain. He eventually rolls over, pounding his fist on the grass right there. Oh my goodness. I am so happy to report that that guy is still alive and he's up and moving. He's a little wobbly. Yeah, I would expect that, but no bleeding from the head and no stretcher. So, I mean, I guess we're ahead of the game right here. Here's Josh Harrison. You know, he had a really nice game. 2-for-2, I think he had a couple walks. So he's figuring things out a little bit at the plate, and that's good to see because, you know, he's an 86 overall. He's a guy we brought in to help this ball club, and he definitely should be able to do that. Oh, there's a pitch that stays up in the zone, and Freddie Freeman does not miss. Two-run shot. You can probably file this under too little too late, but they do strike in the ninth inning and get themselves a little bit closer. Freddie Freeman's second home run of the season, and it goes 402 feet. That's Jonathan Papelbon, by the way, leaving that pitch up in the zone for Freeman to crush. Thank you very much, Pap. All right, 6-3. We got one out, and we got Dansby Swanson at the plate. He has also been struggling a bit, but this ball deep to center field, and it is also gone. Dansby Swanson, it's not his first career home run in the majors. We apparently missed that when we were simming because this is number two on the season. But, yeah, he's been struggling a bit. With the average in this first few games, we have made the decision to go with him in our starting lineup daily and keep him here in the major league level. So he'll grow into things, and this is a sign that the bat is definitely there. 402 feet to center field, and it makes it a 6-4 game. So there's still life. Let's see if they can maybe continue the rally. There are two outs now and a 1-2 count, and that ball's put in play. But it looks like it's going to be a ground out to end the game. The Nationals get the three-game sweep of the Braves, and they are hot out of the gate to start this season. I believe that makes them 7-1 now as they show their dominance in this series. Take it to the Atlanta Braves. So, obviously, not the start we're looking for the season. We're optimistic that we're going to have a better record, but we got to get things going. We're 2-6, and that's not the start we want. Still some work to do, obviously, to get this club where we want it. We'll see you next time for more Braves baseball. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.